Good morning. It's me, Mikey Pipes. Monday, June 27th, 2022. We're on our way to an existing client at a new home. He recently moved in Malvern, which is in Nassau County, just north of Valley Stream, a few minutes from our shop. Call came in over the weekend. His outdoor unit is not coming on, and of course, he's got no AC. Let's go see what's going on, guys. Smash that thumbs up button. Remember, sharing is caring. And if you haven't done so already, I would appreciate it if you consider subscribing, since there's no cost or obligation to you. It just helps strengthen our reach on this platform, YouTube. We love YouTube and we love Bosch. Let's get going. All right, one of the important rules on running a successful service call is respecting your customer's time and also their property. So when I get to a service call and I pull up to the job, I make sure that I knock on that door or I ring the bell within the first 60 seconds. It's showing that you care and you value their time. Keep that in mind. And don't forget to ask, is it okay that I park there? You never know, there could be alternate side of the street parking. If the street sweeper could be coming, or there may just be a sign that you didn't see that says no parking. So keep that in mind, ladies and gentlemen. Let's go.
Good morning.
How are you?
How are you?
Good.
Your familiar face.
Yes, we moved from Oak Street.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
That's American Mr.
Is it okay that I parked there?
Yep,
good.
Absolutely.
Garbage minute. Okay.
Yeah.
What's wrong?
The condenser is not.
Which whole house or first floor, second floor?
There's only one, so
okay.
It's just not starting. It sounds like it's getting power to it.
Is thermostat on or off right now?
It's off now.
It's off. Is the filter clean?
Yeah, I just changed it. So,
okay. Let's turn the thermostat on. Let's lower it to a temperature than what it's reading.
Okay.
And I'll check outside. Which side of the house?
It's right this side.
Okay.
There,
yep. Perfect. Let me check that out. All right. So. Got a unit over here. Looks like someone lost their screen. Put that off to the side. It's hard to read this thing. It's a pain. Looks like we got a 48 maybe. What does that say? It says 46. That's a serial number. 60, so we have a 5-ton here. And what refrigerant do we have? Where is refrigerant? R22. 5-ton R22 system. So we said it sounds like it's coming on, but it ain't. We got a sight glass. We have a filter dryer. Looks pretty clean. Coil looks pretty clean as well. Inside, got a little bit of debris in there. Let's see what she's doing. All right, so we got the contactor pulled in. Oh, this is what we're gonna start putting in now, a breaker. Okay, so I did get a noticeable sound difference once I killed power to the disconnect. Well, killed power from the disconnect to the condenser. Let's get our Veto and see what's going inside this bad boy. All right, I got my Veto. I took out the couple of 5/16 screws there. I loosened up that one and that one. Let's make the cover come off easier. All right, here's our contactor, which is pulled in. There's our capacitor. It's a 65 dual capacitor. All right, I'm suspecting the capacitor, even though she looks fine, I think there's something up with this. So blue is going to Herm, yellow is common, and brown is fan motor. I'm not gonna pull a Ted Cook and use my fingers to make sure it's discharged. I'm gonna use just the needle nose and touch the terminals together. Let's take off the blue wire. This take off the yellow wire, brown, and let's see if we could carefully pull out this cap. Oof, I almost got, almost touched those terminals there. You touch these terminals with metal, you're gonna blow the fuse inside the air handler. Okay, let's get our meter and test this. Okay, I got my Fluke meter, 902FC, set to read microfarads with that little sideways T, and looks like the curved T. And right now we're reading nothing. Let's put that there. And we're still reading nothing between common and herm. Let's do fan to common. And I'm also reading nothing, making sure that the leads are plugged into the multimeter. So we have a bad capacitor here. All right, I got a new capacitor from the truck. Now, a lot of you are gonna say, Mikey Pipes, don't use the Titan Pros. Well, I still have some inventory left of the Pros, but I am replacing the Pros with the Titan HDs. So let's just test this. We're gonna go to Herm. And then we're gonna go to C, make sure that our new one is good. And we have 59.4. I'm gonna go from Herm to fan, and we're gonna get 5. So now we're good. All right, I've resecured the wiring for the compressor, fan, and common. And if any of these are loose, you could take your needle nose and just make those spade connectors a little bit tighter so it doesn't fall off and you have an annoying recall. All right, I'm gonna put today's date on the capacitor. All right, there's today's date on the capacitor. Let's turn on power. And voila, love that hum of that compressor and of course the fan coming on. Let's test our amperage. 19.3, 19.4. All right. If this was a Bosch, it would be literally a fraction of this amperage. Just a test. Alright, we're going to clean out the base of the condenser, get all that mulch out of there, explain to the customer what's going on. Man, it's 8:40 in the morning. I'm already schwitzing like a momser. This 5-gallon bucket, it's got some weight to it. It is literally filled with dirt, mulch, after years of buildup. It basically turns into dirt. Look, I can see the bottom now. Look at that. You can now see the bottom. Literally, I'm gonna guess this thing probably weighs about 15 pounds. Dirt. And when I was scraping, it felt like I was grabbing a wire, but it was actually like roots. This coil don't look pretty healthy. She don't look pretty healthy. Looks like maybe a dog was urinating over there. Some kind of animal, but this side doesn't appear to be that bad, but all right, let's put the cover back on and fire back up. Voila. We'll talk about the bucket next.
Okay.
This is called a capacitor.
Yeah.
It gives the... Sorry, everyone's zooming from work.
Yeah.
It gives the compressor and the fan motor the power it needs to start. More power it needs to start. It's completely dead.
Okay.
Compare it to like a 9-volt battery, giving this toy 9 volts. Now it's not doing anything. Your kids are screaming, yelling at you.
Yeah.
You replace the battery, everyone's happy. I replace the capacitor. Condenser is happy and it's starting to cool now. The bucket filled with about 15 pounds of dirt
is what I took out from the inside of the bottom of the condenser outside.
Okay.
No one's been taking care of this thing properly. I know you just probably moved here or whatever,
yeah,
but
yeah, we just moved here.
Obviously the previous owners didn't really have the equipment taken care of properly, but you can now see the bottom of it, and that bucket is heavy. It's strictly dirt. That's how long it's been there for.
Do you guys do like a service or maintenance
program of course.
Or something
yep,
like that?
We do.
I'd probably do that. Again, we just moved here. I'm kind of like... I pulled the filter out. That was like disgusting too. So
make sure
what we were breathing in.
So the filter, check it every 30 days.
Yeah.
If it's dirty, replace it. Especially in the winter. I don't know if you have an HVAC system, which is heating.
It's forced air.
Oh, forced air. So make sure the filter is always clean year round.
Yeah.
In the summer, if the filter is dirty, the system can freeze up. Eventually, you'll kill the compressor. When you kill this compressor, you'll be replacing your entire system.
Yeah.
It's R22 Freon, it's phased out, didn't make it anymore, very expensive, blah, blah, blah. The condenser is in fair condition. I've seen much worse for that age, but I also see much better, but it could be much better. It does appear to be maybe an animal or something was urinating on the side of it because you could tell by the condition of the coil in that spot. But other than that, you know, it's okay. I would say fair condition.
Okay.
Budget to replace the system though, because it's not cheap.
Yeah.
And something you want to do proactively.
I had to place two of them at my last house.
If you don't want to die in the middle of the winter, you don't want to die on the hottest day of the year, but something preventatively, you know, try to budget for that next couple of years or so.
Yeah.
The system's up and running, and we're good.
Okay.
Just check the vents, close the windows, I'll throw us in the truck, and we'll settle up.
All right, perfect.
Cool.
Thank you very much.
My pleasure. Just initial or sign that white box. The part that we put in and today's labor is guaranteed by us for 24 months.
Okay.
Anything breaks, you call us, we come. If it's our part, we're going to make it right for you. Not charge you anything. If it's something else, we'll cross that bridge when we come to it.
Perfect. Perfect. Thank you very
pleasure,
much.
Sir. Yeah, thank you. Enjoy your week. Enjoy the rest of the summer. Yes, so on the invoice I just emailed you, on page 3 is our parts and labor program. Your system won't qualify that because it's R22.
Yeah.
But the maintenance program is $19.95 a month. We automatically charge a credit or debit card. We come once a year, we do a tune-up, and you know, make sure everything's working fine, blow out the drains, things like that.
Okay,
that's included.
Okay.
You're welcome. All right, ladies and gentlemen. That is how you run a successful service call. Simple repair. And how we interact with our client. We identified the problem, corrected the problem, and also we gave them value. You know, I didn't have to empty out the bottom of their condenser base and remove around 15 pounds of dirt and mulch, but I wasn't going to be in and out of there in 15 minutes either. You know, for my hourly rate, I give my customers value. And if the customer can perceive value, you're golden. That's how you strengthen relationships with your clientele. Plain and simple. You know, he just purchased this new house, was an existing client at his previous home, and now look, we're still servicing him. And we're probably gonna service the last property as well, who knows? As long as our sticker is on the equipment, chances are they'll give us a call. All right, guys, let me get your thoughts and feedback down in the comments section down below. Pop quiz, what did I miss in this video? What did I forget to do, or what didn't I do in video? Put your comments down in the comments section down below. All right, guys, until next time, be well, God bless, stay safe.